very warm good morning to all my dear students. So students, let's start with today's revision class. As you all know that we are doing revision on the very first chapter, Who Will Be Ningdao, from your party book. And students, after finishing the story of the chapter, we had proceeded towards the important textual grammar which has been included here, namely noun. And we have already discussed a lot of important topics relating to noun. So students, before proceeding further towards a new topic today, let us first have a look at the things that we have discussed earlier. So student, in our last discussion, we got the definition of the noun, which refers to the names of things, persons, places, animals and ideas. Then after it comes the different types of nouns. And students, nouns are mainly of 5 types, and they are proper noun, common noun, count and non-count nouns, concrete noun, and at last the abstract noun. So student, out of these 5 types of noun, we have already discussed the first 3, proper noun, common noun, and count and non-count nouns. Now, first of all, let us have a quick look at all these 3 nouns. At first comes the proper nouns. So student, the nouns which are used to refer to a particular person or place are called proper nouns. Then comes common nouns. So students, common nouns are the words used to name general items rather than specific ones. Then comes the third and the last discussed type of noun, which are countable and non-countable nouns. So student, nouns that can be counted are called count or uncountable nouns. A countable noun can have a plural form also. Then comes the non-count or uncountable nouns. Students, nouns that cannot be counted are called uncountable nouns. They are not measured in numbers but in quantity. So student, these are the few points that we have discussed up to our last class. So after that, today we are proceeding towards starting another new type of noun, which is called concrete nouns. So student, in order to have a definite idea of concrete nouns, here I have enlisted 2 examples. So let us read these examples for all of you. Here number 1 is, the yellow flowers float from a glass red vase. Number 2, suddenly a large roaring black panther appeared from behind the rock. And number 3, the sunset unfolded ribbons of red, purple and gold across the sky. So student, you can see that in these sentences, 3 nouns are underlined, and they are flowers, panther and sunset. So now student, just tell me one thing, that can you feel or can you perceive these 3 nouns through your 5 senses? Yes, flowers. You can see the flower, you can touch, as well as sometimes you can smell the flower also. Then panther, you can see it, you can listen to it. Then sunset, you can see the sunset. So these nouns, you can easily perceive, you can easily feel these nouns through the help of your five senses, namely eyes, tongue, ear, mouth, and so student, it means that these flowers which we can perceive through the five senses are called concrete nouns. Now student, for your better understanding, let me give you the definition of the concrete noun. Concrete noun, the nouns which can be seen, touched, heard, tasted or smelled are the concrete nouns. So student, you can see that actually most of the things, almost all the nouns, almost not all, most of the nouns are actually concrete noun, because you can perceive them through your five senses, namely skin, then tongue, mouth, eyes and ears, and you can perceive them through any one, two or three or more than them, more than these senses also. That's why they have been called concrete nouns. You can see that. And say for example, in another example I have enlisted here, the girl is dancing. Here the girl is a noun, and you can listen to the noun, see the noun, you can touch the noun. Means here, in order to perceive this noun, you can use your three senses. They are skin, mouth, eyes and ears. Not mouth actually, I'm sorry. So it means that it is a concrete noun. So student, I hope that you have understood the concrete noun. This is very simple. Almost most of the nouns which we can see, which we can come in contact with in our day-to-day life, are mostly concrete nouns. So students, I hope that you have understood the concrete nouns. Now for your better understanding of the noun, here I have enlisted an exercise, and the question of the exercise is, read the sentences below and underline the concrete nouns. You can see student, five sentences are given, out of which you have to underline the concrete nouns here. So for your understanding, here I have enlisted the answers. Please have a look at this. Number one, I felt pain when dentist took my tooth out. Here two nouns are given which are concrete, and they are dentist and tooth. The number two, I fell in love with that little child. Here the child, it is a concrete noun. The number three, after dinner Holly went out for a walk. Here student, again you have got two nouns which are concrete, and they are dinner and Holly. The number four, my mom will pick me time from school every Monday. So here the concrete nouns are mom and school. Sorry student, the Monday will not be a concrete noun, because it is just a day, you can't perceive it. It is wrong here. I did not, it has been underlined by mistake, because you can't perceive the Monday through your senses. You know only that Monday exists, but you can't see, touch, smell or feel it. Then comes number five, puppy jumped on the table and ate cake. Here we have got three concrete nouns. They are puppy, table and cake. So student, these are the answers. Please note down this exercise in your classwork copy, and mentioning today's date and the name of the topic. And student, still after this much discussion, if you have any kind of doubt, you may ask me in the comment section. And after this student, we are not proceeding further. Again tomorrow we shall read the next and the last type of noun, which is abstract noun. So student, that's it. This is the end of our today's discussion. Again we shall meet tomorrow. Thank you so much for your concentration.